This show is brought to you by PIVX, Private Instant Verified Transactions. With its groundbreaking zero coin staking and masternodes, PIVX is the top privacy currency. Feel free to trade some on Binance or Bittrex. And for more information, go to www.pivx.org.
We are joined this week on ITK Crypto, part of at Smart Reach One on Twitter, by David Pokoi from Smart Liquidity. David, great to have you on. Thank you. How are you doing?
Hey guys, I'm doing great. Feel wonderful.
Excellent. Well, David is the star of the show tonight. He's alongside me, Tom White, and Cryptosi as well. And Cryptosi will chip in along the way as ever. Okay, David, first of all, what we want to ask you is, how did you find your way into crypto?
Everything started from poker. I was playing poker like professionally about 8 or 9 years. And then becomes many news. It's like become like virus. And I hear about Bitcoin. So some kind of coin, it's become grow. And I become interested in it. So I was trying to change or buy, I don't remember exactly. I think buy, firstly. So I was find crypto exchange. Can I call it? It's not a promotion.
No, you can say what you like.
Oh, okay. So it was a KuCoin exchange from ASEAN. And I see they have promotion. In this promotion, you can make some kind of volumes and participate with other traders to win some prizes in tokens. So I was calculated how much is price, how much is present volumes already participants make. And I decided to get in it. I was a little bit scary because it was the first time for me, and I was invest, I don't remember, about $5,000 or about. And I get some price, price in leaderboard, wait about 1 month, and I get profit, like $2,000. Was very exciting. And from this time, I was start bomb hunting other exchanges and trying to find best promotions with same conditions.
So you made some money fairly quickly out of it. And so how did you then get from there, that initial kind of win, I suppose, into Smart Liquidity?
Yeah, so basically these promotions, it is about... you make volumes for some kind of active, so assets, I mean, so for some tokens. So I try to realize why tokens need these volumes. And I understand they need liquidity when they finish ICO. They need more hype, more attention from investors potential. They need more transactions. They need more trades. And I am... cooperate with my teams from poker. We create soft. We start to analyze market, try and experiment some algorithms, and
So you would you describe yourself as a market maker?
What is the service? Yeah, you're asking.
Yeah. What is a market maker? Because it sounds like that's what you're describing.
So market maker, it's some kind of tool that allow to provide liquidity in a type of volumes for tokens. Also, market makers sorry, guys.
Yeah, that's all right. No, it's okay. Yeah. You got the right word. It's stabilized, but it's spelled the same.
Yeah, yes, stabilize.
Yeah.
Spread. So we care about difference between buy price and selling price. So when spread is low, we're trying to make it lower than 1%. So it is better possibilities to buyers and sellers to realize their needs on most acceptable prices, and not overpaying for that assets.
See, there are some people that think that, you know, a market maker is or should be illegal. What do you say to that? Because it's not illegal, is it?
I think I was here at illegal in some states in USA, but in other world, I don't think it's illegal. I'm interesting why people think like this.
Yeah, why do you think that is, and why is it illegal? Some states,
I think market makers sometimes use wash trades, you know, not real volumes providing. It's like for some kind of strategies to bring attention of investors and to create more activity between present holders. But it's a very positive strategy, and professional market makers use it in not a big amount and not big quantity, just trying to combine this strategy with strategy of organic market development.
Yeah, Cryptosi, I'll just bring you in here. What do you kind of, what's your kind of experience, I suppose, with any sort of market maker?
Yeah, well, this is the main reason why I was so keen to have David from Smart Liquidity on the show, was because I was always quite baffled by the concept of market making, because I've not really come from a trading background. So I'm quite baffled by the concept of market making. And over the course of the last few months that I've known David, he's kind of explained to me how the process works and explain to me things like that it's prevalent within regular stocks and shares. You have these kind of services that provide liquidity and make it so that you can buy and sell easily even smaller project or less well-held stocks and shares. So I think it could well be a good service for projects to have, but I do sometimes worry that it can be misused by projects to kind of give the illusion that there are more people participating trading a project than there actually are. And I think that could be problematic. But the other side of it is it is a good service to give, I feel.
It's not just in crypto, though, is it, David? You know, this isn't something that is specific to crypto. This could happen in, you know, other walks of life.
Yes, the service can be used in the stocks, but our experience, our team, we work for now only with crypto. So all attention on this asset.
Yeah. Okay. Do you believe market making is widespread, and how much volume does it account for?
So basically, how much volume we can make for one project? Yes, you just asking.
Yeah.
It depends of project needs. So it depends of exchange. Every exchange have not have different liquidities and different markets. So every market have a different amount of holders and a different amount of shares of these holders, a different market cap and different supply. So we need to combine all these factors, and then we can create a strategy for what we should do, what we need some fixed amount of volumes per day, or need it gradually rise up, or need to trying to organically push price up. So it's all discussing with projects, with representative of projects.
Yeah, that's completely understandable. Now, if someone was considering joining market making, what advice would you give them?
I think it's when you start any business, you need to put attention on all details. So you need to understand from what major factors it is combined. When you want to start market maker, you need a team of traders, analytics who understand psychology of market, their patterns, behaviors. They need good secure soft. They need good trading strategy. For example, we use strategies from famous mathematics like Martingale and Descartes. So we use their mathematical formulas and adopted it to the crypto market. automated it and change it depends of market mindsets. So you need to put it all together and provide good quality service for tokens, for assets.
Yeah, I think just listen to that there. Just, you know, it sounds like good advice to give. I think Cryptosi's got a couple of things that he's just picked up on as well, Cryptosi, haven't you?
Yeah, I was just wondering, David, the projects that use your services, that would use Smart Liquidity, is it possible for them to make a profit whilst using your service?
This podcast has been brought to you by Rhubarb Media. Rhubarb Media are the branding specialists behind successful crypto projects such as PivX, Vendable, and Libertaria. The Rhubarb style is both loved and respected the world over. So if you want your project to appeal to techies and everyday users alike, give Rhubarb Media a try. You cannot possibly be disappointed. Link is in the description.
Yes, for sure. It is depends about what trading balance we use for our trades. So if as bigger balance we use, as bigger profit we can make. So you can understand it is more simple to make $5,000 profit from $1,000 if it compare from $10,000 balance. So it is not only about profit. We provide risk management. So when market catch negative mindsets and price on BTC go down, we manage risks and all actives influenced by price downing less. And when prices go up and BTC go up, so we make more profit.
And then I guess the other way around then, the question would kind of be, is it possible for people using the service to actually lose money? So say I gave you a trading balance of like 100,000 US, would it be possible that, like, not including the fees, of course, would it be possible that I could lose money or that the project could lose money?
Yes, it is possible when Bitcoin will price on Bitcoin will be $1 or $10.
Okay, that's yeah. Okay. What types of indicators could somebody look for to be able to separate a good liquidity service from a bad one?
You mean liquidity indicators?
Yes.
Sorry, I can't answer because I not understand totally your question. It is all about my Russian. Sorry.
Okay. So how can we rank the performance of different market makers? Like how can we say, okay, this one is good, this one is not so good, this one is great.
You mean estimate quality of market making service?
Yes.
Okay, so for me, it's a high level of support. So it's when you can answer and satisfy needs of a client, you can make everything what they need, provide volumes, generate profit, stabilize price, inflate on price that she go up, increase amount of transactions inside ecosystem, separates other liquidity zones on other exchanges. So if you can make it, and if you have like experience, if you have tradings that you can show to your clients, if you have recommendations, yeah, it's possible. It is a mirror of quality of your service.
David, I'm just going to ask you a more general question about crypto. Did you say you're based in Russia?
Sorry, moment. I say what? Russia?
Are you where are you based? Do you live in Russia?
No. I live now in Ukraine, but
Ukraine. Sorry, I shouldn't get those two mixed up. I apologize for that. How is crypto viewed out there in general? Because over here in the UK, there's various kind of you know, a little bit of suspicions around crypto. Some people are very excited about crypto, completely convinced. How is it seen out there?
I see good intentions in Ukraine. Our government looks very positive in this market. So, and more people come in this sphere. So it's good. I very like these tendencies. So for me, especially for me, I'm not using fiat, you know. I'm totally go on crypto. So it's like, it's very nice to see it.
Yeah, because the government, I mean, cryptocracy, because the government over here still isn't, as maybe forward thinking as other countries where, you know, we've spoken to guests on this show, and those countries have been far more forward thinking with crypto, haven't they?
Yeah, and I'm not surprised to hear that Ukraine is another one of those countries that are quite forward thinking. That's good to hear. That is good to hear.
Is there any, again, more general on crypto, is there any kind of crypto project out there, you know, nothing to do with, it doesn't have to be anything to do with market making, that you're particularly impressed by?
You mean projects in Ukraine?
Anywhere, really. Anything that particularly impresses you.
Oh, you mean that we already work with them?
Yes. Yeah, yeah. Or,
yes, yes, we work with several projects, also work with Middle East exchanges in Dubai. So, but I can't say name of projects because we sign in the NDA agreements. So,
oh, I see. Yeah.
Yeah, sorry, my guys.
Yeah, no, that's okay. That's okay. Right, I think we're just about ready to wrap up here. Cryptosi, you've got a couple left to ask, David, haven't you?
Yeah, I just wanted to go through our usual signing off questions. So, really wanted to ask David if he had to invest every last euro, well, every last penny, or what the currency that they use in Ukraine. I'm not sure what it is, but if you had to invest your last one, which project would you invest it in? If you had to invest your last penny into a particular project, which project would it be, and why would you choose that particular project?
You mean in crypto space?
Yes, it has to be a crypto, yeah.
I think I will choose most liquidity assets, so it is Bitcoin. So, because it's too much volatility on other assets, and Bitcoin have more and more popularity, more. If you see last graphic where you can see amount of transactions, now we reach amount when we have in January when Bitcoin was priced $20,000. So it becomes more stronger, and real price now it is not it's not real price, you know.
Do you feel that the price of Bitcoin is being artificially held down right now?
Yes, it's undervalued for sure.
Okay, how do you think these things happen? Do you think that there's, I don't know, it sounds like a conspiracy theory, but do you think there are a group of people who are doing something to keep the prices deflated, or do you think it's just natural market cycles?
Yeah, for sure, group of people manipulate assets of Bitcoin, and now it is more and more hard for them because many people come. Many people invest in Bitcoin, and at some point we reach sometime it will be then influence of big players will be less and less.
Okay, that's really interesting because people do speak about people artificially holding down the price. So it's interesting to have an expert on liquidity actually saying that you believe that that's the case as well. I did actually want to ask some more questions about. With regards to gambling, now that I know that you come from a poker background, do you feel that Bitcoin is a good tool or a good currency to use for things like online poker and online gambling? And do you think that that's a good use case for Bitcoin moving forward?
Yes, it's pretty good because it can be anonymity, it can be fast. If platform which organize gambling business can make it very simple for users, it is best method of payment.
That's quite interesting here, isn't it, Cryptosi? Right then, David, where can people find out a little bit more about you and Smart Liquidity?
Where they know about me, you mean?
Yeah, where can people find out a little bit more about you and Smart Liquidity?
I have a blog in LinkedIn. I put articles about market making, about crypto space, different projects, and just another insightful understandings about business process and about cryptosphere. Also, we have weblink. I don't know, can I say it or I just put down where?
Yeah, you can say it.
Yeah, it's smartestliquidity.com. So you can go on this link and see what we do, what we use, and how we work.
Okay, excellent. Okay, to all the listeners, please go and check that out to find out a bit more about David. And also, please like and subscribe to our YouTube channel here, ITK Crypto. And it's a big thank you to you, David, and thank you again to Cryptosi.
Thank you, guys. Thank you. I really, really enjoy conversation with you. Thank you for your questions, and I wish prosperity and good luck for your project.
Yeah, you too. Good luck. Right, that's it, done. Thank you. Excellent. Thank you, David. Really good. Really good.
Thank you, guys.
This podcast was brought to you by Meros Cryptocurrency. Meros is a cryptocurrency payment system that does what cryptocurrency originally intended to do. Be a practical and secure form of direct payment, Meros utilizes the best of current technology in a powerful new way. It introduces a groundbreaking consensus mechanism called merit caching. This enables Meros to be both feeless and instant while maintaining the same level of integrity of traditional networks like Bitcoin. To find out how you can participate in the future of crypto payments, go to meroscrypto.io now.